So I was about 19 at the time, and I was looking for a job. I was living at my mom's house up north in a small town called Leeuwarden, and I had seen an ad online for a job in a different city called Groningen. Taking the train from one to the other takes about an hour, so it wasn't that far, and I applied for the job. Fast forward about a week later, and I'm invited to do an interview. Like a good boy, I wear my clean white shirt, and I head over there. So the job title was described as a venue auction host. You know those guys that go like, this item for 25, do we have 26? Do we have 26? 25, 25, sold. It wasn't like that. It was actually just offices that were being closed down, where chairs and tables and TVs and whatever get auctioned off. I take my train, there's one train from my station all the way to Groningen station. From there I take the bus and I do this interview. Interview went fine, no problems. They were all kind of like interesting people. They were all very local, speaking in a dialect that I didn't know anything about. But still we kind of got along and they told me they would call me and send me on my way. So I was having a pretty good day. I take the bus back to the station, I grab a croquette, which is like Dutch fast food. If you've never had it, you should have it. It's delicious. And yeah, everything's fine. On my way home, looking forward to making some beats when I get back. Nothing was really the matter. I go into the train, everything's normal. Back then we already had train passes, but I still had tickets. I forgot exactly what it was for, but I think my father had some kind of membership and you can get 25% off if you bring some sort of pass. Anyway, I bought the ticket and I go into the train. It's a regular yellow Dutch train, only one story high. Now everybody that takes the train in the Netherlands always does the same thing. Everybody always looks for an empty seat, and when they find one, they sit on the window side. Trains always fill up the same way. Everybody takes the window seat, and then only when there's no empty rows, people sit next to each other. So I boarded the train at one end, and I walked all the way through looking for one of these seats. I look around, everything's full. I go to the next coupe, I don't know how you call that, cart? I don't know. I move on to the next cart and I do the same thing again. I look around, but I don't see any empty rows at all. Now I was in a pretty decent mood. I had already done my thing socially that day by doing the interview, so I didn't feel inhibited to ask someone to sit next to them. So without looking, I just turned to my right where somebody was sitting and I asked, hey, is it okay if I sit next to you? Now I want to preface this by saying that there's a lot of weird people on Dutch trains. Everybody knows there's weird people on Dutch trains, so we kind of take it with a grain of salt if somebody acts a little bit weird. Anyway, I turn around, I say, hey, is it cool if I sit next to you? And it's this guy. He was sitting like this, the window was right here, and he had a bag right next to him on the seat that I was about to occupy. It was a black bag like this, but not a tote. It was those little things with the strings that can kind of turn into a backpack. Like the sack type of deal that turns into a backpack. You know, Nike makes them, there's all kinds of them. Let's say the bag's right here. Upon me asking him, the guy turns around slowly, he kind of sizes me up for a second and sees that I'm no threat, and he just gives me this really big smile, and he goes, yeah, I don't see why not, and he just grabs his bag and takes it. Actually, he put it at his feet. Now, it sounds kind of weird, and it definitely gave off a weird vibe, but once again, we have weird Dutch train people, and I was like, whatever, I'm gonna sit down and do my shit. I sat down and took out my phone. It was literally my first smartphone, and I texted someone, I forgot who. However, the whole time I'm texting and looking at my phone, you know that feeling when someone's looking at you, but they're not in your vision? Like someone's behind you and you just feel that they're looking at you. You don't see them, but you're very aware of the fact that you're being observed at that moment. Well, that was happening to me, but not conspicuous at all. I look to my right and I see this guy literally sitting there like this. He had a big smile on his face and he was just, I don't know, he just seemed like he really wanted to talk, basically. I didn't know how to react, I just kind of gave him a friendly nod, like, yo. And I want to turn back to my phone, but as soon as he noticed that I was trying to end the interaction, he goes like, how was your day? I was a pretty sociable kid at the time, I wasn't the worst, so I was like, I just had a job interview, and it was pretty good, it was cool, just fine, I guess. I don't know if I asked him how his day was or not, but he definitely did not take in any word I said, and he just looked at me and goes like, I just came from blah blah blah. And I was like, okay. Cool. And he's like, yeah. And he looks at me like super expectantly, like there's something that I'm supposed to know from the word that he said, but it was just, to me, it was just blah, blah, blah. I didn't really react. I just kind of sat there like, okay, cool, I guess. And he realizes that I don't know what the fuck he's talking about. And he's like, yeah, blah, blah, blah. The prison. The way he said it really felt like he was making a big reveal, but I guess it didn't really quite dawn on me what he was talking about. He said he came from a prison. I didn't really associate that with him being the prisoner. I, I, I don't know, I just kind of sat there. And he just kind of kept looking at me. I don't think he took his eyes off me from the moment I sat down. And with the same smile still going, with the same cadence, with the same way he sits, he says, "Yeah, I escaped this morning." I don't know, maybe I smoked too much weed as a teenager, but I still didn't quite get it. And I was just like, okay. And then to, I guess, prove it, he shows me his clothes. It was a black sweater with black sweats or like black jeans. And those type of like ugly cheap shoes that are like kind of sporty, but also look like maybe people use them in construction or something, like those type of shoes. I remember there being a name in like green label type, like here or in there somewhere, I don't know, but he showed me. But then the wild thing happens. He goes and he shows me his hands. I looked at his hands and they just had scratches and dried blood all over them. Now I don't know what the fuck prison clothes look like. I've never been to prison, and when he showed me the clothes, I guess it was meant to prove something, but I didn't know what I was looking for, so I don't know. But the hands. The moment I saw his hands, I just knew that he was for real, and I just got this ice feeling in my neck. All the time leading up to that point, I just didn't take him seriously enough to even consider the fact that he might be an escaped prisoner, because how often do you meet an escaped prisoner? It's not something you consider a possibility. And so my neck just goes cold and my thoughts go faster, and the first words out of my mouth were, "Oh shit, do you need my t-shirt?" I don't know why I said that, but just the first thing I thought was, "Oh, I have a t-shirt under my white shirt and I can give this to him and then he won't get caught." I don't know why I said it. It was hella dumb. It was basically a panic move. And without flinching or losing his smile, he just goes, no, man, that's all right. I don't need it. I think after that, the conversation fell silent and we didn't look at each other. I don't really know for how long. The only thing I know is that I was there straight stressing. My heart was bumping. I still had that feeling in my neck. The only thing I thought was, what is he gonna do? What's gonna happen from here? Dutch trains are noisy. People like to talk to each other. People like to be on the phone. It's not like Japan at all. But I heard nothing. I was just sitting there in my own zone, like, okay, what's the plan? What am I gonna do? What's happening? I contemplated getting up and just saying, well, hey, I gotta go to the bathroom and grabbing my stuff and leaving. But I felt like he might think that's suspicious, like I was going to tell the conductor or something. And so I just sat there. This whole interaction happened within the first 10 minutes of me getting on the train. So we still had like 40 or 50 minutes to go until I was home. Now somehow, definitely through him, because I would never initiate that, but the conversation got started again. He stuck his bloody hand out and I shook it and I introduced myself and we had a conversation. He still had that same gleam in his eye and he looked like he really wanted to get his story off his chest. And I guess I was gonna have to bear that. So he starts talking and talking and talking. He said he basically just climbed the wall or fence or whatever it was and he walked through a field. He said that after that field, he reached the farmer's house and he told the farmer to bring him to the station. Apparently, the farmer turned him down, saying, "I want to drive you to the station, but if I would, I'd be an accomplice." And so he just walked. He tried to hitch a ride, but nobody stopped. He starts asking me a bunch of questions about my life and I answer them, and it wasn't even a terrible conversation, to be honest. He asked me if I was from Leeuwarden. I said I was. He said he was too. I honestly don't remember that much of it because one scary thought popped into my head. What if we get checked for tickets? It is super normal on Dutch trains for somebody to come by and check your ticket. The conductor. They always dress the same, they have the little black uniform. I forget if they have a hat or not, but they come by and they check your tickets and they stamp them and move on. I used to take the trip from Leeuwarden to Groningen a lot, and I'd say it's about a 75% chance that you're gonna get checked. So me and this guy are talking, and he's telling me weird ass stories. He told me every big company in the Netherlands has a bunch of strong guys behind him to like rip each other off and do extortion. He told me about fights he'd been in. He told me he was related to like a mob family kind of. At this point, I'm kind of calm. Like I can have a conversation, but I still feel like anything might happen at any time. So I'm still ready to jolt whenever it's needed. The main thing going through my mind, honestly, was just what's gonna happen if we get checked. He's sitting here at the window, the conductor's gonna be here standing over us, I'm gonna be in the middle, what's gonna happen? So I came up with a solution. I was like, you know what, if we get checked, I'm gonna slide him my ticket and I'm just gonna take the fall for it. In the Netherlands, getting a fine for not having a train ticket is like 50 euros, which is like 60 bucks, maybe even less. So I was like, you know what, I'll pay that just to not be in the middle of all this. I just want to go home safe. The thing that I forgot though was that I had my father's coupon thing. You can't take that discount unless you have the pass, and you're gonna get fined equally for just taking a discount than you will for not having a ticket at all. Time goes on, we're still in conversation. I found out that the reason that he was in prison in the first place was for beating somebody up and threatening some other people. Crazy part was, he only had to be in there for like 3 weeks. It wasn't like he had years at all, he literally only had to be in there for like 2 or 3 weeks. Why he would want to get out and make his life even more complicated, I don't understand, but that's how it was. Now, my hometown Leeuwarden has only 2 train stops. It's a small town, all we have is the 2 train stops. The first one is a neighborhood that my mom lives in. The place where I grew up. I had to go to my mom's place, so I was planning to go off at the first stop. Which was good for my situation because most of the tickets get checked between those 2 stops. The rest of it is countryside where people don't really skip tickets. Conversation's still going. It's still just this guy talking to me about stuff. I'm checking my phone like crazy, and after what feels like forever, we're finally starting to get close to my stop. The only thing on my mind the whole time is please don't get checked, please don't get checked. No conductor, no conductor. Let's not do this. I don't know if this was before or after, but right around the time they announced that they were gonna stop at my stop, the door to the cart opens. It was none other than the fucking train conductor. The cold in my neck was instantly back. I was panicking. I was full on panicking. I'm sitting there in my chair looking at the train conductor and I look back at the guy. He looks back at me and maybe he knows what I'm thinking. I don't know, to be honest. He kind of still smiles and looks in front of him for a second. The way that these coupes are laid out is that they have rows of seats and then the exits and then rows of seats. Now we were right in front of the exits and the conductor came from the other side. So what I figured would happen was the conductor would start checking from there and then slowly make his way to us. I grabbed my ticket to give it to the guy just in case. But the conductor doesn't start checking over there. Instead, he walks toward us. The feeling in the back of my neck intensifies. My heart just goes boop, 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 boop. I do not know what is happening. Why is he walking this way? But then he just doesn't even look at us and he walks past. I guess what I didn't realize was they walk all the way to the back and start checking from the end and work themselves way back up front. This sounds like it's gonna be bad because we're close to the exit, but actually we're in the second cart. So he exits our cart too and goes to the first one to check the tickets there first. Now they had already announced my stop and I feel like the train was starting to slow down, so things seem to be all right. The idea came up in me that I could just be like, hey, this is my stop, and stand at the exit and wait there. But I didn't want to give him the chance to follow me. So I stay quiet and I just sit there and I just hope that this conductor does not come into the door. The train starts to slow down, my heart definitely did not. And then, out of nowhere, this fucking guy says, well, this is me, and he grabs his bag. For a second, I didn't know what to do. I was like, okay. And I just stand up and I let him go out to the door and I sit back down and I'm like, fuck this, I am not getting off this stop right now. He shakes my hand with his bloody hand and I'll never forget what he said. He said, let's get a pot of beer sometime. He didn't say a glass of beer, he didn't say a pint of beer, he didn't say a can of beer, he said a pot of beer. I don't know why that specific detail stuck with me, but it just stuck with me. He goes out, I sit down, stay on the train, go into the main station. Conductor comes around, checks my ticket. I have the ticket, 25% off with the thing. I give him the thing. Everything's fine. I had a friend that lived about 15-minute walk from the station. I didn't even want to take the bus anymore. I just walked from that station to my friend's house, still with some adrenaline. I arrive, I tell him the entire story, and the first words out of his mouth were, ugh, this could only happen to you. And I was like, bro. Stayed at my friend's place for a while, then walked from his place back to my mom's house, and everything was fine. Next day, we checked a bunch of news sources, but there was no news on the whole thing, which is kind of weird and sort of leads me to believe that this might be a more common occurrence than I would think. But yeah, nothing at all. I never saw the guy again. We never got our pot of beer. Everything was fine. I actually got hired for the auction job and did that for a couple of months, but the travel was just dumb and it was minimum wage. It wasn't that fun. And yeah, that was the story of how I met an escaped convict on the train. It's one of my weirder stories, and since I asked you guys for the most scary thing that happened in your life on the last episode, I felt like I had to share my own. I don't know if I would rank this as the scariest, but definitely the most noteworthy one. And that's all she wrote. Do you like these story times? Do you think they're fun? I never really know what you guys like the most, so if you guys are into this kind of thing, I can do it more often. though I will run out of stories at some point, of course. Which I honestly don't mind, because it forces me to go out there and live more crazy and make more stories happen, basically. So telling you all my weird stories is not a problem for me. If you have any particular things in my life where you want stories about, maybe they're related to Pepe or Japan or whatever, back home, doesn't matter, let me know and I'll consider it. It's like 8:30 and I gotta edit this right now for tomorrow because I gotta work at 6. I'll see you guys tomorrow.